Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to play with UDES 1516 aka Udestein. I hope I spelled that properly. There is a new cam on this vehicle, I believe every single of you know that. And for me, fellas, this 3D effect is looking epic. It is looking quite nice. If I'm not mistaken, you could get this camo for free for completing certain missions, right? And here we go. And I thought, why the heck not to play one battle with this vehicle? Well, one battle. Why not to dedicate a video for this vehicle? Because quite funny thing, fellas, I know there is a lot of split opinions and majority of the people saying STB is the best. For me, I love UDES equally, if not even more. I truly love this vehicle. I think it is awesome. And with a new camo, I can review it once again. So why the heck not, fellas? So let's do that. Also, a happy incoming holidays, fellas. Today it is 21 from of December, right? So we are getting very, very close there. So if you are celebrating Christmas early, happy Christmas to you, my lovely friends, and I wish you all the best. And probably most important thing nowadays is health, fellas. It is health, right? Okay, let's see. What the flying F can we do here? What do you think, fellas? Jack Peasley saying, good luck, have fun, no hate, except against this map. I hate it. Well, not a big surprise, is it? So what is the options? What we can do? There is two clickers, which is not very, very good thing. And to be fair with you, I don't really want to get clicked by them, but we'll see how the things is going to look like. By the way, in the battle, as you can see, this 3D shiny effect is still here. And we are having dance party, fellas. And we are having dance party. Beautiful. Okay. It is you. Nope. I'm fake. Let's see. There is... It is going to be a huge lemming train, my friends. Huge lemming train. I'm trying to go for a snapshot, the hashtag never lucky, but that's completely fine. And once again, my mission kind of is to spot people which is crossing here through the open field, right? This is in a way my mission. Now 277 might think he did everything properly here, and he is not necessarily incorrect, but what we are pretty much doing in this position, I am trying to spot people which is trying to do some kind of crossing, or should I say silly goose crossing, right? That's very, 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 very important thing. And in a way, I don't really want to go there because of the almighty clickers, right? Which is not going to be very, very fun, fellas. Because clickers can shoot this this position without bigger problems whatsoever. So we want to be patient here, okay? Patience is going to be one of the most important things for us. And soon, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, soon we are going to go for a base death. Or maybe I should do that even now. I'm not entirely sure. Anyways, 277, 60TP, E5, all of them is thinking about starting banging this 277, right? That's important. Wait, fellas, wait. We have all time in the world of tanks, wait. We need to be very, very patient in this battle because this is going to be extremely, extremely hard one. What I could do, I could eliminate this guy by making hardcore pressure like this, okay? I could definitely eliminate this guy. But in a way, I kind of need one more guy to make a pressure together with us. But we'll see how the things will go. Track at the IS-7, it is completely fine. This is what I wanted, fellas. That's what I was aiming for. Lower plate shot, beautiful. 408 in the face, that's nice. He's still tracked and he's considering his life choices. And in fact, he's dead. Beautiful. That was a mistake which we was waiting for, right? Now look. This Jack Peasley is extremely, extremely dangerous because if we will try to cross, he might hit us in the face. This is definitely not what I want to see, right? This is not what I want to see. Okay, beautiful. What is happening? Our mouse is making a hardcore pressure together with us. He even said he is going for it. So we are going to make a pressure like this. That's a beautiful, beautiful play. Our mouse is saying blah, 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 blah. He's going in front like there is no tomorrow. Obviously, he took a bit for the team, but once again, that's not a big surprise. And we are eliminating this guy from the game. Beautiful. This guy is down to 2 shotable, so soon we will start working on him. But before that, can we find the shot on TVP? No, we cannot. Okay. Next thing what we are going to do here, we are going to go for this guy. Not a big surprise, he will more likely track us and everything, doesn't really matter too much. Jack Pizda missed his shot and now I'm going to reload quicker than this guy will. This is exactly what we are looking for and this is exactly how we want things to go. Next, what we are going to do next, we are making a hardcore pressure ID here. Fellas, if you want to cross here, remember you need to push a bit sideways, 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 sideways. Ooh, that's actually very, very slow, I might die here. Uh-oh. Woo! I was worried for a second. I did not build it too much speed, but it's okay. Whew. Never ever worried. Skill, are your diapers full of kaku? Absolutely, yes, fellas. For a second, I thought I'm going to be Jeff, which is drowning himself when the things is not going too well. So yeah, that was close one. Anyways. You know, fellas, it doesn't really matter because this is a good ending story, so this is the most important thing for us, right? And TVP is probably reloading currently. Currently, he's working on the reload. That's exactly what we want to see, right? Can we smack him once like this? I'm thinking about it, and sure we can. We still have 600 HP left, and we need to hunt enemy Jeffs before it's too late. It's not epic battle, but in my opinion, we played this battle well, and in a way, we kind of provided a victory for our team together with that mouse when we decided to make a super duper hyper turbo big pressure, right? At least in my opinion, it was very, very valuable part of this. Obviously, by any means, other people which was defending the base, they did a very, very great job too, right? We definitely cannot complain about this. So here we go. 3,700 damage, 1,000 assisting damage, and how about some strip dance, fellas? What do you think? Is it possible or is it not really possible? Probably not really. Nice. I mean, that was a great game. Honestly, fellas, I'm very, 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 very happy with this battle. I am very, very happy with this battle. And if you are wondering why we did not make the pressure for the enemies before, because I was simply thinking it's not really worth it. That's what I was thinking. It was way, 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 way too risky. Anyways, great score, top by the damage, top by experience, 3,700 damage, 1,200 assisting damage, 178,000 profits because of some kind of mission, right? So, yep, let's keep going. One more, or probably two more games, fellas. I love this tank. I could play this tank forever and ever, honestly. I truly enjoy this vehicle, and obviously, one of the most important things right here, which I truly want to ask you, fellas, what do you think about this 3D style, and what do you think about the UDES yourself? Do you think it's good tank, do you think it's bad tank? Obviously, after that style question, do you think it's looking good, it's looking dope, or it's looking like a big pile of kaku, and it's looking like a cheap pornography of the lava, or volcano, or whatever, right? So I'm quite curious what you have to say, right? Because once again, everyone is looking into the 3D skins from their own way, right? From their own perspective. And in the same time, I can quickly tell you, my friends, if you are not a big fan of the UDES and this tank is on sale, You don't need to buy the skin in order not to play with a tank which you don't like, if you know what I mean. So keep this in mind, fellas. Keep this in mind. Not a big deal. Everything is fine. We are going through the open field here because obviously we can afford it, right? Now the question is, can we punish someone who is going like this? I assume this Leo is the first one, right? Is he going to cross like this or he is going to go there? That's the question. Aha. Smart cookie. Smart cookie. Okay, this is not what I am looking for. Remember, there is three artists, and this is definitely not how we want to play this battle, although maybe this guy is going to get banged by our clickers. Meanwhile, enemy Arta missed us for 400 HP, like literally missed. We was hiding behind the rock or behind the stone, however you are calling that, and it's not what we are looking for. Okay. Maybe, fellas, we want to deal with this object 279E. Maybe we could do this. What do you think? Maybe we can do this. Do you have hits, sir? Okay, very nice. Budget is making a hardcore pressure here. That's good. We can punish this guy in the side. That's very, very nice. Budget is kind of getting effed himself, but in a way that's completely understandable. We are trying to punish the 279E in the side once again. That's very, very good. Our budget is going to die. That's even better because he's in my bled list. And to get into my bled list, it's not too easy. Our T57 is right there and he is getting slaughtered. You know what? There is only one way how we can do this. I will start making a hardcore pressure for this 279E, right? And my goal is going to be to eliminate him from the game, right? Before it's too late. And as you can see, 279E is sitting right there. Doesn't really matter. He just missed his shot. That's even better for us. He's thinking I'm going to go this way, but I'm tricking him and I'm going this way. And we should be about done. Beautiful. Okay, when we eliminated this mother trucker idea, I'm feeling so much better and so much more confident, right? And now we are playing against the Object 263. I believe we should be able to track him without bigger problems if I would not suck a massive PP while aiming, which is sometimes happening, right? But once again, it is how it is, not much what we can do about this. It's still, in a way, morning, so you know. Everything is fine. Meanwhile, this guy is quite angry on me and T57 heavy is kind of dead. It is okay. It happens. Sometimes it happens, fellas. T57 was truly about to help us, but you know, it is how it is. Although, since this guy is on the reload, the T57 death is not going to be unnoticed, right? And since he baited the shot of this guy, we managed to pick it up, right? That's very, very good thing. Now, other thing, what the flying F we supposed to do here? We need to eliminate the Leopard somehow, and this is a big fat problem. And this is a big fat problem. I mean, to go for enemy Artas, it's truly not really worth it. At least that's what I want to believe. And I'm thinking how to get a better angle towards the Leo. And Leo is already gone, GG, finito. Everyone actually drop it down here. That's quite interesting stuff, I would say. Okay, how about that T49 then? Where the flying if the T49 is hiding yet, huh? That's the question. Is he still on top of the hill? Because this should be the case. And obviously, E50 is getting spotted by the same T49 which is here. So what we need to do, we need to fast, fellas, fast. And I truly mean fast. Go on top of the hill and simply eliminate him from the game. I'm very, very, very aware of the enemy Artas. But this is the road and this is the way which I want to take and which I need to take, right? And once again, we are about to get into position where I want to be, my friends. We are about to get into position where I want to be. He should be somewhere here. Beautiful. He just shit his pants. I can promise you that, fellas. His pants is full of shit. Right now, beautiful. I took two for the team. That's one too much than I wanted to take. But honestly, it is not changing anything, fellas. It is not changing anything. It's game over either way, right? Meanwhile, can we eliminate this guy from the game? That's the question, and answer is sure thing we can. Oh, yes. Our clicker is saying thanks for support. No problem, Jeff. No problem, Jeff. Pleasure is mine. I am glad you asked for it. E50 saying 13 losses in row, probably. Aye, aye, aye. I mean, not the most enjoyable gaming experience, but fellas, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, keep this in mind. You cannot win every single battle, and nowadays World of Tanks in a way is 15-4, 15-1 simulator. Either you are winning, either you are losing, and one in three battles or so you are getting a bit more equal game, right? Just how it goes, my friends. Just how it goes. This is the world which we are living in. Anyways, considering the situation, considering the battles, this is top damage performance, top experience performance. I think I did, honestly, everything properly, and this wasn't so bad whatsoever. I need to say thanks for this guy. Hey mate, thanks for help. And I'm not being sarcastic there. This T-57 actually tried to help us, and he actually did a good job in a way, right? He did not notice that the trash burn, shit happens, trash burn killed him. We managed to pick up the trash burn without bigger problems whatsoever meanwhile, right? So it wasn't that horrible, right? Okay, let's see. What is the plan for us here? The third battle with Udestein, or the evil UDES, or the lava UDES, or however you are going to call this vehicle, right? The question is, where to go and what to do? I think there is a couple of very, very simple options. As an example, one option is to play here, to stay hold down, which is pretty much working all the time. Another option is to go into the city, but I don't really want to do that. There is no light tank, so I could go through the middle of the field here, but once again, it's extremely, extremely, extremely risky strategy. So I am not entirely sure is it worth it or not. Is it worth it or not? Meanwhile, phase one is wants to go into platoon by, and he is having name artillery boss. Buddy, that's way too close, my friend, for being a Jeff yourself, just saying. Obviously, it is his name. He can be even Pussy Slayer 69, it's completely up to him, and everything is working just great, so all good. Anyways, the first shot into the 430U, that was quite nice, to be fair with you, fellas. That was quite nice. Now, what is our mission and what do we want to do right there? We want to punish this guy which is making a hardcore pressure. Is it some kind of camo or what the fuck? Why this guy is looking so weird? Fellas, why this guy is looking so weird? Maybe it's because morning for me. Maybe that's why I did not recognize the 54... That's why he was looking a bit different than usual. I mean, that was some kind of camo, I assume. Anyways, look at this. Tanking sideways. That was impressive play by the IS-4. But once again, fellas, we cannot blame him too much. It's still morning, right? We are using the same excuse right here, left, right, and center. So, the question is, can we actually play in this position and not get completely banged for our stupidity? Answer is C. We can. Beautiful. We managed to outspot the Centurion, which is always welcome and always very, very, very nice. And now we have the information. We have pretty much three guys which is playing in this area, right? That's very, very good to know, my friends. That's very, very good to know. And fellas, if you are wondering, what do I like more over UDES, for UDES over STB, right? The answer, Arta is here. Jeff is here. Nice, that was a beautiful blind shot, fellas. I need to give a props for a clicker, that was actually a nice one. I'm relocating, I'm going to switch the sides and I will charge through this side. Anyways, what I wanted to say, fellas, UDES have better alpha damage. That's why I love UDES so damn much, right? For me, UDES armor is way more trollish than STB1, which is obviously a good thing. I truly love the alpha damage, and you know what? I don't really mind the gun handling either on this vehicle. And I am even using optics instead of using ventilation, right? In other words, for me, this vehicle is working better, and it's just fitting with my style. And believe me, fellas, I am extremely well aware of that. There is like plenty of people which is saying, or which would say, STB1 is better. And you know what? I respect your opinion. I agree with you, fellas. If the tank is working better for you, everything is completely fine. By the way, they have spotters somewhere here. Honestly, fellas, they have spotters somewhere here. So you know what? I am actually considering about making a hardcore pressure. Wait a second. Could I get spotted by this eye? Aha! What did I said? God damn it! I'm good, fellas. I am good. I notice that immediately Mother Trucker is spotting us, right? And we need to bank him before it's too late. That's the most important part of all this. And you know what we are waiting for now? We are waiting for now. And just in case, fellas, we are going to be ready to spot. We will be ready to support our guy here. Anyways, you know what? I have another idea. How about if we would make a bit of pressure like this? Fellas, how about if we would make a bit of pressure like this? And as you can see, this guy is going to die very, very soon. This guy is dead, and this is exactly what we wanted to do, fellas. This is exactly how we wanted to approach this this progetto. And now our goal is going to spot this guy here, okay? Since I am a medium tank, I should have a better time outspotting him, right? All we need to do, we need to follow this bush line here, right? This is exactly what we want to do. And T-30 is sitting next to the red line. This gun is actually very, very beautiful, fellas. Look at that shot. That was sexy, fellas. You can say whatever you want. That was sexy. Now, he is dead. Yip, yip, hooray. Now, the other mission is to get rid of this heavy tank. For this heavy tank, I'm going to make a massive, I repeat, massive pressure just straight towards him. Why so? Because I can afford it. This is the first thing. The second thing, because he is armor act. And since he is armor act, he doesn't have his head. He's not big of a threat when it's raining. You know, cabrio rain, cabrio rain. Yep. Beautiful. Okay. There is only one guy which never ever was spotted. If I'm not mistaken, it is Bobject. And I could bet Bobject is sitting somewhere here, right? So how we are going to do the things, we will try to make a bit of pressure in front, and hopefully we can pick up some assisting damage for obvious reasons, right? We can pick up some assisting damage for obvious reasons. Beautiful. I mean, I don't know how about you, fellas, and even though this session wasn't the most exciting, speaking about the score, you know, it's not 14-15 or something, right? It was kind of one-gated games, but I am simply kind of used to that, right? And I truly mean it. I'm kind of used for this kind of gaming experience already, and instead of crying too much about 15-1, 15-5, I am just trying. Fellas, I repeat, I am just trying to get as much use as I physically can with the current situation which we are having in the game, right? In other words, instead of saying shitty ass balance and disgusting and so on, I'm trying to think from the different angle and how to be in the pit point of the charge, right, when we are going in front. That's how we can get maximum use when we are winning the game. When we are losing the game, then I am pretending I'm the toilet paper and I'm hiding in the toilet, okay? Then I'm being more passive and then I'm trying to get more use in this way. Anyways, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful performance, fellas. The third battle, once again, top on damage, top on experience. Three games, fellas, three times on top by experience and damage. Call me idiot, but this is a great performance. Overall, our average performance of this session was solid 4,000 damage and 1,300 assisting damage, which I would rate very, very, very great performance overall, fellas. So, if you enjoyed this video, feel free to smash that like button. It helps a lot to get recommended for a people which never ever or saw the YouTube channel, so that's nice. And in the same time, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, remember you can motivate skill by subscribing to the channel too. It is free, and I hope you are having a great time for yourself, right? Anyways, thank you so much for watching. See you very, very soon. Skill is out for today. Peace.